The Lord has risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. On this Easter Sunday, we look to celebrate the rising of our Lord, his victory over death in the grave for us, transforming us and changing the world forever.
I will sing the wondrous story of the Christ who died for me, how he left the realms of glory for the cross on Calvary. Yes, I'll sing the wondrous story of the Christ who died for me. Sing it with the saints in glory, gathered by the crystal sea. I was lost, but Jesus found me, found the sheep that went astray, raised me up and gently led me back into the narrow way. Yes, I'll sing the wondrous story of the Christ who died for me. Still may need me sorrow's path I oft may tread, but his presence still is with me by his guiding hand I'm led. Yes, I'll sing the wondrous story of the Christ who died for me.
Easter Sunday is always a day of great joy, and it seems really weird not to be physically in the same space as others, to rejoice with others. It is a completely different feeling this year, and not one I'm particularly comfortable with. But in reflection, I think that Easter itself is something we shouldn't be comfortable with. It challenges us to view things differently, to see the world in a different perspective, through a different lens. We mentioned for Good Friday that it became Good Friday much later in the church's story, when they looked back through the lens of the Sunday, the lens of the resurrection, and could see that it was good. I think we are invited to look through the lens of our lives and see how it's different because of Easter. because of what Christ has done for us. So as we come together to reflect, can we take a moment in prayer? Let us pray. For the joy of Easter, Lord, we give you thanks and praise. For the resurrection glory that inspires us and lightens and fills our hearts, we thank you. As we bring our worship as best we can, may we see that being a people of faith is more than the place in which we meet, but it's the lives we lead through Christ our Lord. Amen. As you'll hear, I've still got my cough, that tickle at the back of my throat caused by sinus thing. Hopefully it won't be too distracting, but it is very annoying. This is a song, you'll all know the words, but the tune might be new to you.
The Lord's my shepherd, He makes me down to lie in pastures green. He leadeth me the quiet waters by. My soul he doth restore again, and me to walk the maze.
Turn to scripture, the bit that's been speaking to me in these days leading up to Easter has been the bit of the appearance of Jesus to Mary Magdalene as recorded by John at the 20th chapter of his gospel. Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white, seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they've put him." At this she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she didn't realise that it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it that you're looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you put him, and I will get him. And Jesus said to her, Mary. She turned towards him and cried out in Aramaic, Rabboni, which means teacher. Jesus said, do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them that I am ascending to my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news. I have seen the Lord. And she told them what he had said. Amen. When we reflect on that bit of John's Gospel, we see a woman in grief for apparent loss, desperately looking for something that had been, and then being offered something new, something more. Not the old story, but a new story. Not the old relationship she had with Jesus, but a new one, a different one. And her relationship with God transformed. He's going to be with his Father and our Father, his God and our God. We are now part of that family, fully integrated. And I feel that at this time of social separation, when services are closed down and we can't meet together, there are some who feel that the church is dead. It is finished. It is, in aspects, set aside. And they look forward only to the day when we can walk through that door again and we have church. But is this not church? Is taking time to connect and communicate and to share the heart of the gospel, to encourage one another, that's church, isn't it? So no matter how we do that, whether electronically at a distance, whether face-to-face, given the opportunity, whether in writing, whether we send someone a letter, a card, no matter how we do that, that is church, that is Christ in action in the world. That is what we are called to be, that's how we are called to respond to the resurrection. Not to sit in the garden looking at the tomb in tears, but to see our risen Lord and return rejoicing to our friends and say, the Lord is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. So even when this current situation is resolved and the church is open again and we have our services and it's great to meet together and to celebrate together, I hope we don't see that as the be-all and end-all of church. I hope we can see that church is more. And if we want to see the reinvigoration, the resurrection of the church, we can't look for it in past models, because it will have to be something new. In the resurrection, God did something new in this moment. He's still trying to tap our shoulder and get our attention and say, here is something new. It's still church. So as we celebrate Easter, the fact that the Lord is risen, whether we're only doing it with our immediate family, whether we're doing it on our own, may we hear within the echo that God has a purpose and a plan to do something new. And we are invited to be part of that plan. And that is glorious. And that is joyous and joyful. So I wish you the very happiest of Easters, even in the current situation when we can feel the stresses and the strains. May the knowledge of the risen Christ overwhelm all of that and give us a new perspective. Not for the past, but for the future.
My Redeemer, there is no more for heaven now to give. He is my joy, my righteousness and freedom, my steadfast love, my deep and boundless peace. To this I hold, my hope is only Jesus. For my life is my Redeemer, there is no more for heaven now to give. He is my joy, my righteousness and freedom, my steadfast love, my deep and boundless peace. To this I hold, my hope is only Jesus. For my life is wholly bound to His. Oh, how strange and divine, I can sing, all is mine, yet not I, but through Christ in me. Night is dark, but I am not forsaken, for by my side the Savior He will stay. I labor on in weakness and rejoicing, for in my need His power is displayed. To this I hold, my Shepherd will defend me. Through the deepest valley He will lead. Oh, the night has been won, and I shall dread. I know I am forgiven, the future sure, the price it has been paid. For Jesus bled and suffered for my pardon, and He was raised to overthrow the grave. To this I hold, my sin has been defeated. Jesus now and never is my plea. Oh, the chains are released, I can sing, I am free, yet not I, but through Christ in me. With every breath I long to follow Jesus, for He has said that He will bring me home. Day by day, I know He will renew me, until I stand with joy before the throne. To this I hold, my hope is only Jesus. All the glory evermore to Him. When the race is complete, still my lips shall repeat, yet not I, but through Christ in me. When the race is complete, still my lips shall repeat.
Invite you to join with me in a brief prayer. Let us pray. God of Easter, of every day, of resurrection, living and life, we thank you for this reminder, this annual remembrance of all that you accomplished, not only in the cross but through the grave and in your rising again, that we are joined to you eternally, that we are forgiven, we are renewed and restored, that we can have life in all its fullness, in all its richness, and in all its joy. We thank you for this season, Father. We thank you for the obedience of our Lord. We thank you for the presence of your Spirit. We thank you in all of that. The gospel is lived and breathed. Father, as we seek to share the hope of Easter, of the beyondness, away from the tomb, out of the tomb, from darkness to light, may we be resurrection people. May we live in its hope. May we live in its joy. May we live in its enthusiasm and its love for others. And so on this day we give you thanks, but we also remember those who feel their lives are stuck in the tomb, in the place of death and darkness. Lord, we pray that you would lead them out, back into life and living. We pray for carers and those who guide us and lead us, that you would inspire and direct them, confirm their decisions, enable their plans. We pray for communities who perhaps are beginning to rediscover what it means to be a community, of looking out for each other in a way that is different from the past. May we not lose that, even when things return to so-called normal. Lord of all grace and glory, we thank you for each other. And though we may be separated in different houses, unable to come together, we are reminded that in Christ we are one. We are always one. We will always be one. We are not alone, for Christ is in us. A great hope of the resurrection. The Lord is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah and amen. As you'll know, not all hymns work successfully on different instruments, so we'll give this a go and we'll see how we get on.
Mine be the glory, risen conquering Son. Rolled the stone away.
May the joy of Easter fill you. May the hope of Easter transform you. May the power of Easter flow through you now and always. Amen. The Lord is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.